It is indeed a great opportunity to be here with all of you. I feel that there are five generations present in this hall. I saw people in their retirement age. I saw people in their middle age, like us. There are also young people over the age of 18, and also I saw children, two children below the age of 18, and I'm sure there are children in the mother's womb among these 600 participants at this conference. So it's a, I feel, a unique gathering. I'm here today to share with you the story of a people's movement in Sri Lanka. I'm not going to give you a kind of a scholarly interpretation of this particular theme. I'm going to share with you the story of a movement called Sarvodaya. Sarvodaya, the word Sarvodaya was coined by Mahatma Gandhi. Sarva is all. Udaya is awakening. Of course, in Sri Lanka, Gandhiji interpreted this to mean goodness of all. In Sri Lanka, we gave a sort of a more elaborate interpretation, meaning awakening of all. And we believe that lasting peace can only be ensured through cultivating inner peace. So in Sri Lanka, for the past 56 years, Sarvodaya was born 10 years after the declaration of the UN Day, October 24th in 1958. The seeds of love as well as hatred do not grow in the soil of Mother Earth, but in the hearts and minds of us, her children. Human beings who are endowed with the consciousness that no other living species are endowed with. So we believe that inner peace is basically cessation of conflict within oneself. So outer conflict is a manifestation of an inner conflict. So in this spirit, for the past five decades, we have been working with Buddhists, Christians, Hindus, Muslims, and also with people of all different races. And also, Sarvodaya is operating in all parts of Sri Lanka, irrespective of race, religion, ethnicity, or any other divisions. And transforming the egoistic mindset, if we are to experience outer peace with the human, animal, and the plant world, we need to transcend our consciousness from our egocentric way of thinking in terms of me, mine, my family, my religion, my race, my village, and my country, to an all-embracing universal consciousness that honors and respects the well-being of all sentient beings. Buddha made the radical discovery that we do not live, exist as separate beings. So he saw self is a delusion that causes suffering and alienates us from freedom and the mystery of life. Therefore, Sarvodaya promotes and adheres to the Buddhist principles of loving kindness towards all sentient beings, translating loving kindness into compassion. And out of that, you develop sympathetic joy, altruistic joy. So from personality awakening to family awakening, village awakening, urban awakening, Sarvodaya has been conducting and implementing programs throughout the country. effecting in uplifting the lives of villagers. We all know that social and economic inequalities and also political injustices creates a certain feeling of mistrust and also a certain feeling of injustice and also a certain feeling of helplessness. So we have been implementing programs, social empowerment programs, economic empowerment programs, and also legal empowerment programs to address those these social, economic, and political inequalities and injustices. Our societies are plagued with social evils such as all forms of violence against women and children and older people, and also children addicted to also people addicted to various forms of dangerous substances. So Sarvodaya has been, while taking care of the people who have become victims of violence, we have also been helping perpetrators of crime to come out of their hateful minds. So these are some of the work that we have been doing in villages, and also in what we call Shramadana, sharing of labor. You get Buddhist monks, Muslim women and children, Hindu women and children working together. It's not just a love or loving kindness is not an ideal. It's something that you translate loving kindness into compassion. And through Shramadana, we try to connect the hearts and minds of people belonging to different races, different religious backgrounds. We say, we build the road builds us. So this is basically the essence of Sarvodaya. So with this, with the village awakening, we have gone to the national awakening. You all know Sri Lanka was, we had an unfortunate war for 3 decades. And so we have been basically trying to address the root causes of the war and help people directly and indirectly affected by the war to go through a social and a personal healing process. So we have mobilized hundreds and thousands of Buddhists, Christians, Muslims, and also belonging to all different races and religions. This was during the war, when there were bomb blasts, rocket launchers. Amidst all this, hundreds and thousands of people walked for peace. I'm sure our brother will be able to quickly go and show you the 1 million people meditating in Sri Lanka for peace. Some more, please. This is the Colombo main jail. When I say healing the hearts of perpetrators, this is all 5,000 people, inmates in the Colombo main jail, meditated for peace. This, you can see Muslim inmates as well as Buddhist inmates. This is 1 million people. The Commonwealth Summit took place in this premises, inside the building. So 1 million, this was during the war. Muslims, Christians, you know, in this you can see people walking and doing peace marches, trying to connect with each other and learn from the essence of love, learn from each other. And we have also tried to create a political consciousness for the well-being of all, brought all the religious leaders through a national awakening. You can see Buddhist monks seated on the right-hand sides and Muslim men and religious leaders on the left-hand side. This took place last year. So there's so much work being done to promote inter-ethnic. It's not just attending a meeting. It goes beyond attending a meeting, but translating loving kindness and compassion at the family level, individual level, community level, and also at district and national levels. So with these initiatives, we hope that we can influence the so-called policymakers and key opinion makers in the country to embrace loving kindness and compassion and work towards well-being of all. Thank you very much,
sir. Thank you.